This is DVTV on the web, brought to you by Driversity.
The surge in hate crimes against Asian Americans only getting worse, and some of the accounts are extremely violent.
91-year-old man pushed in Oakland's Chinatown, one of three attacks that day. 84-year-old Thai American Visha Ratanapakti knocked over while out for a walk. He died a few days later from his injuries. Asian American leaders say these attacks are a trend, not isolated incidents. Asian Americans Advancing Justice has cited at least 3,000 anti-Asian incidents since last February. In New York City, there was an 867% increase in Asian hate crime victims in 2020 compared to the year before.
In 2020, hate crimes against Asian Americans has skyrocketed up to nearly 150%. The issue of anti-Asian hate crime is something that has to be addressed, especially in the mainstream medias. All we can do as a small media company is try our best to give voice to the people who are in their own affected community. Let's find out what's their take on this situation. What are your thoughts on the hate crimes against Asian Americans?
As an Asian American myself, I feel like it's making me even more stressed on top of the pandemic and stuff. Like, it's making me fearing for my own safety. And it's sickening that our elders are being targeted, knowing that they are the most vulnerable members of our community.
I think it's really like unfair, and I wish that like everyone can be equal with everyone and respect everyone's race and like religion and like everything.
Yeah, so why would you want to be that type of human to bring others down just because of the way they look? It's been really bad for Asian people. And you know, we heard not that long ago about the shootings in SF at the hair salons. So it's been really bad. And elderly Asian people too, they're being targeted just because of the virus, and it's bad.
Why do you think hate crimes against Asian Americans are happening at this time?
Currently, I think it's just because of what other people are saying. And you know, since like social media, everyone's been using it mainly because it's like a way to entertain yourself in quarantine, so people get bored easily. And it's just basically what you read online, like, I guess it influences some people.
Well, I think there's always been Asian hate crimes, and like it didn't just come out like overnight. I think it really like increased since like our previous president Donald Trump like started like saying different stuff, saying that the COVID-19 is like because of Asians, or like that like Asian people have it, and so like other people are like reflecting from it. They're kind of like hating against us because of that.
I think it's because people want someone to blame or a group to blame. They want a scapegoat. I also think that it's because of the whole stigma that like, Asians caused COVID or gave COVID to us or whatever. And it's making people aim their hatred towards the AAPI community.
How has these Asian hate crimes affected you and those around you?
Well, like, I think it's like seeing everything happen like online is really scary. And luckily, like, it hasn't happened to anyone around me, to my loved ones. So I'm grateful for that.
Personally, it hasn't really affected me because I don't go out much. But I know for some people, it's like, it's hard for them because, you know, they're just doing their own thing. And it's just people are just, they're just racist and they get in the way. They let their thoughts like speak out, you know?
Like I said, it makes me fear for my own safety. I also have a sister that lives in Daly City currently, and she tells me that she's afraid to go to the grocery store even because of the hate crimes being committed in that area. And I myself am afraid, of course, knowing that any of us can be targeted on the street.
How can we bring this problematic situation to light?
Well, we can first spread information about it on your social media and your friends and family, and then you can also stay aware and also inform others.
I think what we could do is bring it up on our socials, you know, spread awareness.
The best thing we can do is to be aware of what's happening, spread awareness on social media and stuff, and like you're doing right now, listen to other Asian American experiences. And reach out to Asian American friends.
I hope different races of people can understand each other's history and also celebrate what is different, because that's also the beauty of our nation. So have hope that it can be stopped, speak more, and let the voice be heard as well. Because at the end of the day, what matters most is protecting those that need it most. Stand up for what is right and unite.
Hey, you guys just watched a Group 4 production.
This is the God. Oh, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe while you're at it.
Follow @YourGolly TV on IG for more content.